And in did come the strangest figure. His queer long coat from heel to head was half of yellow and half of red. And he himself was tall and thin, with sharp blue eyes, each like a pin. With light, loose hair, yet swarthy skin, no tuft on cheek nor beard on chin, but lips where smiles went out and in. There was no guessing his kith and kin, and nobody could enough admire the tall man and his quaint attire. Quoth one, "It's as my great-grandsire, starting up at the trump of doomstone, had walked this way from his painted tombstone." He advanced to the council table, and, "Please, your honor," said he, "I'm able, by means of a secret charm, to draw all creatures living beneath the sun, that creep or swim or fly or run, after me, so as you never saw. And I chiefly use my charm on creatures that do people harm, the mole and toad and newt and viper. And people call me the Pied Piper." And here they noticed round his neck a scarf of red and yellow stripe to match with his coat of the selfsame check. And at the scarf's end hung a pipe. And his fingers, they noticed, were ever straying, as if impatient to be playing upon this pipe, as low it dangled over his vesture so old-fangled. "Yet," said he, "poor piper as I am, in Tartary I freed the cham last June from his huge swarms of gnats. I eased in Asia the Nizam of a monstrous brood of vampire bats. And as for what your brain bewilders, if I can rid your town of rats, will you give me 1,000 guilders? "50,000! Was the exclamation of the astonished man corporation. Into the street the piper stepped, smiling first a little smile, as if he knew what magic slept in his quiet pipe the while. Then, like a musical adept, to blow the pipe his lips he wrinkled, and green and blue his sharp eyes twinkled, like a candle flame where salt is sprinkled. And ere 3 shrill notes the pipe uttered, you heard as if an army muttered. And the muttering grew to a grumbling, and the grumbling grew to a mighty rumbling, and out of the houses the rats came tumbling. Great rats, small rats, lean rats, brawny rats, brown rats, black rats, grey rats, tawny rats, grave old plodders, gay young friskers, fathers, mothers, uncles, cousins, cocking tails and pricking whiskers, families by tens and dozens, brothers, sisters, husbands, wives, followed the piper for their lives. From street to street he piped advancing, and step for step they followed dancing.
until they came to the river Weser, wherein all plunged and perished. Save one who, stout as Julius Caesar, swam across and lived to carry, as he, the manuscript he cherished, to Ratland home his commentary. Which was? At the first shrill notes of the pipe, I heard a sound as of scraping tripe and putting apples wondrous ripe into a cider press's gripe, and a moving away of pickled tubboards, and a leaving a jar of conserve cupboards, and a drawing the corks of train oil flasks, and a breaking the hoops of butter casks. And it seemed as if a voice, sweeter far than by harp or by psaltery, is breathed, called out, "Oh, rats, rejoice! The world is grown to one vast dry psaltery. So munch on, crunch on, take your nunch on, breakfast, supper, dinner, lunch on." And just as a bulky sugar puncheon already staved like a great sun shone, glorious, scarce an inch before me, just as methought it said, "Come, bore me," I found the Weser rolling o'er me.